I'm just showing you one of the many days that I take out during the week. I start out with some pancakes, strawberry pancakes, homemade. And I'm just showing you how my hair looks after 1 month of braids. I had African Marley twists, I believe, for about a month since December. And I put some fresh aloe vera in it for some pre-poo. And I had a lot of shredding. But the aloe vera kind of helped me with that. As you can see right here, pretty moisturized and pretty shrunken. This is just a close-up of texture and the aloe in my hair. Just went ahead and decided to do some other things while I let it sit for a while before I shampooed it. And one of the things I did was I started to make some flaxseed gel. This wig cap I had since I did my big chop about 6 years ago. I don't wear wigs at all. I'm not gonna say really. But I just use a wig cap and put it in the measuring cup. And then I'm just gonna pour my flaxseed gel. I use 2 cups of water and about 1/4 cup of flaxseeds, whole flaxseeds. And I let them boil for probably like 10 minutes. And then I took the pan off of the stove and let it cool off for about 35 to 40 minutes. And now I'm just scooping out the flaxseed gel into the measuring cup. Very, very gooey. Trying to make sure that I get all of the gel. All of it is needed. So I'm showing you the jar I'm going to use to put the gel in. Wig cap and tie it at the end that's open so none of the seeds come out while I'm trying to squeeze the gel out of the wig cap. And then I start squeezing. And I'm just going to speed this process up a little bit. It's a lot to watch. You could probably see that I dropped some gel on the counter. And I'm making sure that I use every single little drop of gel, and I put that gel back in that measuring cup. I recently got eczema on my hands, and this moisturized my hands so well. It's very, very moisturizing. The finished results. While I was waiting for my hair to dry after I put the gel in and conditioner, I just made myself some dinner, which is some vegan spaghetti I made homemade, and also some homemade slices of French cheesy bread. This is my style after my hair dried. I was going for a wash and go look, but I just decided to put it up in a puff. Just showing you guys my shirt. And now I'm going to show you how I make some vegan chopped cheese with some vegan ground beef, plant-based beyond meat. Just frying up the meat first. And I did the onions separate because my boyfriend doesn't like onions. So I'm going to put the onions and a teeny bit of green peppers on my sandwich. So now I'm just separating the meat. And I'm going to add some vegan shredded cheese. It would have been much better if I had sliced cheese, which would have helped the meat stay together, as you'll see later on in the video. And this is just some homemade peppered relish that I made also. I might put the recipe of this up later if I make some more. So I toasted my bread, put some vegan mayo on it, sliced some tomatoes for my sandwich, and then I also cut up some potatoes to make some french fries. Use a little bit of olive oil, black pepper, use a little bit of garlic powder, and some total seasoning, which has like lemon pepper, has garlic in it too, I think black pepper as well, and a little bit of other different kind of seasonings, and I also threw some thyme leaves in there. And then I mixed it all up, make sure every piece was coated. Spread everything out evenly though. While the potatoes are cooking in the oven, I'm going to clean up and do some other duties. Wash dishes, catch up with some worldwide news, and then I'm going to come back and start preparing the sandwiches. This is my sandwich, of course, because you see the onions and the tomatoes on it. This is what I was saying. If I had sliced cheese, it would have been so much better to keep the meat in place as opposed to the shredded cheese. It's just chopped meat falling everywhere. And the potatoes are done just in time after me preparing the sandwiches. I'm just gonna plate them up on the plate. I didn't really try to melt the cheese as much because I planned on warming the sandwiches back up later before we eat. Then I add a little bit of vegan-free buffalo ranch. This is the end of the video. Please comment, like, subscribe, and check out my Etsy page. There's t-shirts, stickers, jewelry, art. Let me know what you think.